Well, good afternoon. What a delightful day. The decorations are great. I know the horns are all tuned up, but I ask for you maybe to do some things to tune up. If you would, if you've got a cell phone, would you please turn it off at this point? Because today, CGTV5 is here with all three cameras doing a very good recording session. And if we had a little jingle, extra jingle now and then, it might be kind of confusing to the people that listen. So if you turn those off, that'll be wonderful. Welcome to the 22nd Annual Christmas Concert. It's hard to believe. The Circleville Pumpkin Show Community Band, directed by Clifford Kerns. Would you please stand for the playing of our national anthem, the Star Spangled Band.
Before we play the Star Spangled Banner, I'd like to ask for a moment of silent prayer for our bass drummer, who had congestive heart failure night before last, or maybe last night, and is in the hospital ICU. A moment of silent prayer, please.
Continue now our concert with a stylized arrangement of an old familiar tune by James Boyhar. It's called Jingle Bells Fantasy.
Thank you.
like about Christmas is the fact that all the tunes you hear, you've heard over and over and over, and it's just kind of wonderful. But I want to tell you something, when a group this good plays for you, when you applaud for them, you just have to really go over the edge and just let them know how much you appreciate it, so that every year they just keep getting better and better. So remember that the next time you applaud. Just give it everything you got. Our next piece is entitled, Do You Hear What I Hear? Written by Noel Regney and arranged for band by Jay Boca.
Thank you.
give them just a little chance to take a break here, but how many of you got your shopping done? All those folks, raise your hand. Have all your Christmas shopping. That's very good. Have you bought a gift card? There was a thing today that says don't give anybody a gift card because they want to spend more than you give them. So they just go out and keep spending, so it was a bad deal. And the other thing I like is now you can order online. They'll ship it to the store next to you, nearest to you, and you can go pick it up in 5 minutes guaranteed. I like that for Christmas. Technology is quite a thing. I wanted to talk to you about what we have here. Well, we're all inside playing and enjoying listening to the concert, and these folks are with these TV cameras. Sid Liming's out in a truck trying to make it all go together so they can reproduce it and make a playback a little bit later. But it reminds me how technical things are all of a sudden, just more difficult. And so I found a little poem. Now, if any of you can remember what black and white televisions are, this is how they felt about black and white TVs. You could hardly see for all the snow, so you spread the rabbit ears as far as they'd go, and you pull up a chair to the TV set, good night, David, good night, Chet. Depending on the channel you tune, you'd get Rob and Laura, or maybe Ward and June, or Andy Griffith and Barney Fife, or Lawrence Welk, or maybe a show called This Is Your Life. I Love Lucy and the Real McCoys, Dennis Semenis and the Cleaver Boys, I'm sorry, Rawhide, Gunsmoke, Wagon Train, Superman, and Lois Lane. Father Knows Best, Hattie Duke, Rin Tin Tin and Lassie Too, Donna Reed on Thursday night, life looked better in black and white. Well, they were simple folks, living a simple life, where everything always turned out right, the good guys always won the fight, and I want to go back to black and white. Well, nowadays, nothing is the way it seems. In living color or on the screens, the good guys don't always win the fight, and life doesn't always turn out right. If only I could, I'd rather be in a TV world of 1963. It felt so good, it felt so right. I guess life really did look better in black and white. Well, I'd trade all the channels on the satellite if I could turn back the clock tonight to when everybody knew wrong from right, life was better in black and white. Thought you might enjoy that. Well, the band's next selection are themes from the Nutcracker Suite. The march is a joyous, bright, and spirited section. The dance of the Sugar Plum Fairy is featured. The main theme in the original score was written for a celesta and is assigned to a muted trumpet that you'll hear in this band's score. Arabian dance is characterized by dark moods and exotic melodies. The Waltz of the Flowers is the brilliant and popular waltz from the ballet. It adds melodic beauty and richness to this whole selection. Russian dance closes the piece in a tray pack. Fiery native dance, which builds to an exciting close. Themes from the Nutcracker Suite by Peter Tchaikovsky.
Thank you.
Hey, it's been pretty nice so far, hasn't it? So I can just nod if you want to. Can't see a nod on television, though, so I guess next time you applaud, you can be real loud so they can see you on television. I get to give a commercial. It's for the Sounds of the Pumpkin Show Band. I understand there are a few of these left. If you're looking for something for Christmas, someone you want to send somebody, they're real small, probably Lowell Butendorf would even deliver one for you, as long as it wasn't in Peoria, Illinois, or something like that. But they'll be available at the intermission a little bit later, so you might be thinking about that. Well, while you're thinking, Leroy Anderson believed that musical ideas came to his mind simply because he was just constantly looking for a new idea. Anderson used sounds from the real world for Sleigh Ride, as you're going to hear. But more important than the nostalgic bell sounds and the horse whinny and the whip, those types of things, the melodies and the scoring are excellent. And this has made it part of band's repertoire forever. You might want to share with an audience and a band whose limb is resting, that's what he calls it. The easiest way to find something lost around the house is to buy a replacement. That's one thing he says. And he says, an unbreakable toy is useful for breaking other toys. Dick's quite a guy. You like Dick. Other thing he says, if quitters never win and winners never quit, then who's the fool who said quit while you're ahead? I thought that's pretty good. We ought to make that into a big plaque. I don't know where to put it, though. If you want your spouse to listen and pay attention to you and hear every word you say, talk in your sleep. Here's one I like. It says, what has four legs and an arm? A very happy pit bull. I'm expecting Dale DeLong to groan any minute. How's this for a Christmas gift? For people who like peace and quiet, a phoneless cord. You know what a shin is? A shin is a device for finding furniture in the dark. That's my brother-in-law talking. And the last one he says, do you ever stop to think and then forget to start again? You have to meet him. He's a character. Well, the next song is called Have Yourself a Merry Little Christmas, and it features Nikki Smiley on the trumpet solo.
Thank you.
now we're going to take a little 9.5 minute intermission. During this time, in the back, there'll be someone who has some of these CDs available if you'd like to buy one. I've got a little gift for you in the back if you want to take something you can stick up on your refrigerator when you go home. But pick up one of these. I'll make an awfully nice gift. Set your watches. Get ready. 9.5 minutes. Here we go. Sucking on the reed, getting it wet for her while she was gone. Well, I hope you had a good chance to buy a CD during the break. Lowell says we're down to the final few before they get to make another one. So if you still have that in your mind, we'll give it a little break a little bit later. Some other folks I want to thank. I started earlier and didn't do it. It's our CGTV5 crew. We have John Stout up at the top there. We have Stuart Cox over here on this camera. We have Will Shirey on the other camera. And the big guy, the man in charge, is Sid Liming. And Sid's in the truck outside, freezing to death. I don't think there's a heater in that truck, is there? There is a heater, a little tiny heater. Well, we want to thank Sid. Are we ready? Okay, The American Christmas Festival by Frank Harrison is the next selection to be played by the Pumpkin Show Band. The songs and the carols and the melody are all of American origin with one possible exception, Joy to the World. It's based on the music by Handel, who was a German, the words by Isaac Watts, who was an Englishman, but it was Lowell Mason, an American, who brought the words and music together in the form that we hear it today.
Before we play this number, I'd like for you to welcome a Marine back from Iran. He's been here for a few years, and we're glad to have Jared Matthew with us on euphonium. Jared, stand
up. Thank you.
young lady in our church, Elizabeth Matz, whose mother is Melissa Matz, grandmother Louise Howard Matz, and she's going to do, she has choreographed and she's going to perform to one of my favorite Christmas songs, and perhaps yours, White Christmas.
Usually at least four. John Baptiste Calkin wrote Carillons at Christmastide using his familiar carol, I Heard the Bells on Christmas Day.
Thank you.
When you hear all the music, you get all the Christmas music, don't you sort of wonder if it's really snowing outside? I think we did leave a concert one year and there were great big snowflakes outside, so today that might be a possibility. Adolphe Adam was a French composer of some renown during his day. His greatest successes were in the field of ballet and comic opera. Cantique de Noel, Adam's most popular work, has become over the years very much a part of our traditional Christmas music. Harold Walters has skillfully transcribed his favorite music for performance by this concert band, featuring the French horns, the euphoniums, and Jeff Matthew on trumpet solo. Gets this band to come to their house for Christmas. Can you imagine finding them under your tree? Wouldn't that be something? That'd be great. Well, this time of year when the boys and girls are all being so good, I just wanted to take you back to maybe before it was Christmas season, some stories that I picked up from my brother-in-law. One day, a little girl was sitting and watching her mother do the dishes at the kitchen sink. She suddenly noticed that her mother had several strands of white hair sticking out in contrast on her brunette head. She looked at her mother and inquisitively said, "Well, Mom, why are some of your hairs white?" Her mother replied, "Well, every time that you do something wrong or make me cry or unhappy, one of my hairs turns white." The little girl thought for a little while and she said to her mom, "Mom, how come all of Grandma's hairs are white?" Another little kid, and I'm sure he's probably in better behavior now than he was, the teacher was giving a lesson on the circulation of blood. Trying to make the matter clearer, she said, "Now, class, if I stood on my head, the blood, as you know, would run into it, and my face would turn red." "Yes," the class said. "Well," she said, "then why is it that while I'm standing upright in an ordinary position, the blood doesn't run into my feet?" One little boy in the back said, "Because your feet ain't empty." I don't know what he'll get for Christmas, but I'm not sure. And the last little group of kids, the children were lined up at the cafeteria at one of the Catholic elementary schools for lunch. At the head of the table was a large pile of apples. Somebody had written a note on the apples that said, "Take only one, God is watching." Well, moving further along in the lunch line at the other end of the table was a large pile of chocolate chip cookies. One little boy wrote a note that says, "Take all you want, because God's watching the apples." Well, George Frederick Handel achieved lasting fame in one of his 27 oratorios called Messiah. The Hallelujah Chorus was a favorite of the Queen of England, and so this song has been respected by people all over the world. The Hallelujah Chorus, the Messiah.
Thank you.
Well, I'd like to thank you for being a great audience, and thank you, everybody, for turning off your cell phones. That was great. It's been a wonderful concert. The band is in rare form today. They're getting ready for the Christmas spirit. And again, talk to them if you wanted to come and play a private party at your house sometime. Wouldn't that be a thrill? I have 60 people at your house for them. Thank you, CGTV5, for being here. And my name is Gary Dean, and on behalf of everybody in the band, we appreciate you being here. We invite you now, the members of the audience, to join and capture the spirit of Christmas in the best possible way by singing. Please lend your voices to the band's accompaniment in a good old-fashioned sing-along.
Thank you. Thank you. I want to thank you for your support for the Pumpkin Show Community Band for the last 27 years. I want to thank you, Lowell, and the band for your help, particularly this last year, showing me where the promotos are, the cesareas, changes of time signature, and tempo markers. I also want to thank my family, Janice, Teresa, Laura, David, and particularly Marjorie, my wife, who has been a support and encouragement to me for more than 60 years. This last year has been very difficult. My vision has gone to the point that I no longer can see to read. With that, I've turned in my retirement to Lowell and the band, and I would like for you to meet and please give him the loyalty and dedication that you have me. He's a graduate of Ohio University, played in the 110 marching band, was a squad leader there, has done student conducting. He's the director of the former Elk Singers, a good friend of mine and the band. I'd like for you to be introduced to your new music director, David Winter. David, are you here?
Conversation a while back and discussed this, and I was speechless at that time, and I'm still pretty much speechless. One thing that Cliff didn't maybe point out in my resume, that he was my band director from the sixth grade on. And when I came and was playing with the band with my kids, a lot of people would say, well, what's changed about music? Not much. I got the same band director. I only hope, as Clifford said, that the community can support and the band will support. A band is not a direct. I guess I look back real quickly at the Ohio State football season and their quarterback that has won so many accolades. Every time you won an accolade, he always said, it's not me, it's the team. Well, these people over here are the team. See you in the spring.
Merry Christmas, everybody.